Hello friends, welcome back to My Beautiful Gardening Life, and today I'm going to talk about this beautiful plant. It's an Epicia. It's also called as a flame violet plant. Here in collection I have three varieties. Now when I'm saying varieties, I mean the color of the leaves. Well, this plant is a very common plant, you can say, in the Central or the South America or the Brazilian region, and it is a lesser known variety of the African violets, which is also another very pretty plant. Now, this plant is been grown by many plant lovers because of its foliage. Of course, the size of the flower is very small, but it does add a splash of color to the already existing lovely leaves. Epicia plants are so common, okay, among garden lovers, that they have been grown in hanging baskets because they have this plant which leaves out runners. Okay, they are also called as stolons, means they just come out from the center of the plant and it kind of just trails down from the pot. And it looks really pretty when you have this runners just flowing down from the pot. All plants thrive if you give them the right environment and take their care. So here I'll just like put in some points so that you enjoy the foliage of this plant all throughout the year. So let us start with the soil. Now here the soil mixture that I have used is a very well draining soil because this plant does not like to be in wet and soggy soil. So I have used an equal proportion of vermicompost, garden soil and river sand. So these three makes the soil really well draining. The required nutrients can be easily absorbed by the plants with the presence of. Moving on to the water requirement of this plant. At the start, let me tell you, you cannot water this plant with a watering hose. You have to use a mug so that you gently pour it by lifting up the leaves. Now, many a times if you're spraying water, the foliage of this plant gets damaged. Another way to water them would be to use bottom watering as a technique so that water is absorbed from the lower part of the pot. Also, watering here would be when you check for yourself whether the topmost layer of the soil is dry, and this can be done by just inserting your finger and checking whether an inch or two is dry. Moving to the propagation of this plant is the easiest to propagate. I have done it so many times. What you have to do is just identify a very healthy runner of this plant and just about cut it at the edge of it and insert in a soil which is well draining, which I have mentioned earlier. Another way to propagate this plant is to choose a very healthy leaf, which is a mature leaf, and insert again in a well draining soil and wait for it to leave or give out new leaves or new growth. It is also said that this flowers leave seeds behind and also can be propagated using the seeds method. The next aspect is the sunlight. This plant does not require direct sunlight. Actually, the meaning of the word Epicia is in Greek means shady. That means it requires shade and not direct sunlight for its growth. If you notice, some of the leaves of this plant in this pot are burnt because they have got a slight exposure on one side to direct sunlight. Give it a minimum of 8 hours of bright indirect sunlight and it will give you many flowers. Moving on to the fertilizer requirement of this plant. This plant requires fertilizing at least twice a month if you want this regular flow of flowers. Last, I had used this bone meal fertilizer for both these pots and they had given me considerable amount of growth. Well, this plant does not require much of pruning, but it would be wise to like just pluck off old leaves or dead leaves, because it would promote and encourage fresh blossoms. Okay, so in case you have not added this to your garden, kindly try to do so, because this small trumpet shaped flowers, which are often in red and pink, do add lovely beauty and happiness to your spaces. Thank you so much for watching.